there's a lot of talk in Charlotte about economic mobility and kind of like if you're born into poverty, you stay in poverty. It's really critical for me to come back to Charlotte because I feel like the city actually like raised me, and I didn't want girls here to miss out on opportunities, on a lifestyle that could really change their trajectory. My name is Khalia Braswell, and my home is Charlotte, North Carolina. INTech Camp is an organization where we teach girls how to be creators through technology. Our mission is to inform and inspire girls to innovate in the technology industry. If I were able to do all of these things, and I'm a product of Charlotte, what can I do to give back to the girls here and just show them that there's a different way? Apple for people in tech is like the holy grail. It's like, I made it, right? And I think Apple really was like the true tech company that I was able to work from growing up in Charlotte, born in Rocky Mount, which really did change my perspective and make me fall deeper in love with technology. I got my first computer in the fourth grade. It was around income tax season time. My mom gave me the question of, do you want a pair of Jordans like my friends had? Or would you like a computer? And I guess it says a lot about me because I chose the computer. So, you know, I was super excited, like this big gray box and like what it could do. I remember playing the Mavis Beacon teaches typing game, and it was just fascinating to be able to learn, okay, well, I'm gonna teach myself how to type. I knew like, okay, technology is something that obviously I'm like super into, and the rest really was history from there. The tech industry as a whole just is super dismal when it comes to women in tech, especially if you drill down even deeper and get into Black and Hispanic women in tech. You just don't see them a lot. If you are at a company day to day, a lot of times you can be the only one. And so it's like, well, how can we change that? I just felt a tug to do more. It was a huge leap. Apple really was the first full-time job that I had, and I decided to quit to move home, and so I felt a little crazy, and I just felt like I needed to do it and give INTech 100% at least for a year. A lot of our INTech scholars are amazing. So they come to us, some of them never having exposure to computing in a formal way as far as education goes. And we are that spark for them. And you just don't know the impact that you'll have on a scholar until they come back.
I do not think that I'd be interested in technology if it wasn't for INTech, because for me, that really was the beginning point. Before then, I really had no clue what I wanted to do. It's pretty much like every other kid. I would say I wanted to be a teacher or a doctor, but I was just saying it, but I didn't really have a passion. But I think that camp just opened me up to a whole new world. And I think women are capable of doing anything, whatever we put our minds to. At the end of the day, we just cannot let these stereotypes and these words that are said to us keep bringing us down. Like, we are the ones who have to make that change and make it happen.
I always describe my experiences as like, you know, me running INTech and being around our scholars really encourages me to work in tech, because it's like I'm fulfilling our mission, right? Like, I am a woman in tech and setting the example for them. But then being with them, it's like, okay, like I want to do this more. Like, how can I, you know, continue to help encourage you and inspire you to be in tech? You know, even though I'm younger, I'm impacting lives all around me, and I don't take that for granted at all.